ओके सो लास्ट टाइम यू सी दिस इज लेक्चर थर्ड लेक्चर सी दिस कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्ट्रेस एट ए पॉइंट इज एक्सट्रीमली इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल इंजीनियर्स टू यू नो टू हैव देयर वर्क बिकॉज वेदर इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी फॉर सिविल इंजीनियर्स इट इज फॉर एवरीबडी यू मस्ट हैव In fact, some 25 years ago, one professor of metallurgical engineering, then metallurgy, now it has become material science and metallurgy. So he came to me, he wanted to learn the basic concept because he wanted to start working in those days something in material science. So what you need is this concept is extremely important. Stress at a point is defined by 9 quantities. And we put them, somebody asked me last time, sir, what is this quantity, 9 quantities, stress. Is stress tensor, is a something physically mean anything? No, obviously a matrix or does not mean anything. 9 quantities put together, that is only we have arranged them in, you know, so many rows, so many columns. But as such, it is a mathematical quantity for manipulation. Otherwise, it means nothing, but each one of these 9 quantities, they have some physical significance. So, you, in order to define stress at a point, you need a minimum of 9 quantities. Okay, so stress at a point is only can be known if you know all this, and that too I am referring to three you know orthogonal coordinate system, and we have taken Cartesian system. So, I will just try to draw and show these quantities on a, so last time you see, let us see, so if I have my coordinates, x, y, z. So, then this plane, of course, this origin is here in one corner, which is inside the cube. So, this is, I have drawn a cube of length, it is not, it is a, you know, length is not important at the moment, but then we have got three faces, let us say x face, it is positive x plane. Why it is a positive x plane? This plane. Why it is positive, explain. One, yes, please. Yes, if you draw an outward normal to this plane, then that is in a positive coordinate direction. So, it is a positive x plane, and then stresses on this we have defined earlier. We have defined what is stress acting on a positive x plane. Do you recall or not? By some quotient, by some division, you know, that means a force df divided by dA, particular one that we have defined in the limit as the area of this plane reduces to 0, because it is stress at a point. You cannot have a finite plane, you cannot have a finite volume, you cannot have a finite area, you must, so it is in, so this is, so I will show that stress. So you have defined a, now I will show it by only the stress quantity that I have defined. So, this on this plane, you have, so this one is tau xx, this is tau xy, this one is tau xz, xy, xx, xy and xz, these are subscripts to tau or tau. Then is it okay? Now I am not showing it by not dividing and then writing limit, because these quantities have already been defined. So on a positive x plane, these are the stresses that are stress components. There is one normal stress and two shear stress. The ones which are parallel to the plane, they are called shear, and the normal one is the normal. Normal one is also denoted by another symbol, sigma x. Is it okay? Shear is as will shear stresses will remain as they are. So there is, you cannot have by some other notation. No, x y and x z. How many people understand this? Is there anyone who does not understand? Has some doubt? Because if you don't understand, you will not understand anything what will be covered in future in the subsequent classes. This is the trouble with this course, and in fact many courses in science and engineering, that if you miss one, the link is broken. So this is what happens. If you sleep in the hostel and if you say, no, today let us say I'm not feeling well, let me relax, so I will attend tomorrow's lecture. So tomorrow's lecture will be a waste. And that is how we become disinterested. So if you don't attend one, next time you will come, you will not understand, then you say, oh, I have wasted my time, I did not understand anything. Other one, again you will come next day, you will find that you are not understanding. So it is very difficult to understand anything in subsequent lecture if you miss anything in the previous lectures. So this is unfortunate, but this is what it is. So I'm just appealing to those who are in the habit of absenting themselves from attending. You can read from the book. Yes, books are there, because this course, this subject is more than 150 years old. So not one book, at least there are 500 books on this. This is only one. Okay, so this is, there are 500 books available on this subject, and this material is available. You can read, but then it will take time to understand. Okay, so now you have a y plane. Is this positive y plane? Is anyway, except for the air from the top, now seems to be everything has stabilized. I think you can hear me. I can also make out the, yes, you can hear me. So this is a positive y plane, and on a positive y plane the stresses that will have to be shown, you have in the positive coordinate direction. Stress directions will be in the positive stresses will be in the positive coordinate direction. Is it clear? Don't try to draw in any, somebody just draws a line and then shows, he doesn't want to be very specific, so he will show it something like this, so that the arrow will not be clear. So these are very, very distinct arrows in the positive coordinate direction. So this is a positive coordinate direction on this side, and this is, conventionally we draw it on the center of the area, not necessary, it is on this, because anyway these are defined, we have expanded the area only for convenience or for understanding, otherwise it is stress at a point. This whole cube has to be squeezed and you have to make a point. So we have drawn a small cube around it and then expanded. This is what you think. We have drawn a small cube and we have expanded it. So then these are in, so what is the one? Yes, it is, the first subscript has to be y. So this is yy, this is tau yz, and this one is tau yx. Tau yy can also be written as sigma y. Now go to the third z plane. And here okay, so then this one is tau zz, tau z y and tau zx. So these are the positive stresses acting on positive planes, and we have drawn on the three orthogonal planes, positive planes, these stresses. Now you must note here that of course sigma x, sigma y and sigma z, they are in the coordinate direction, normal one, because normal is fixed in the, but then this one, this and this, see they are both, see zy on a z plane in y direction, see this is this direction, on a y plane in z direction, both are pointing towards a common edge. Now let us call this as some, let us give name. So this one is O, okay, this is I will say A B C D, okay, I will write it B dash, C dash, then what, D dash. I have complicated the issue by putting it origin here, doesn't matter. So it is both these arrows are going towards the edge CC dash. So both are right angle, so then this is very important. So one is going like this and other one is like this on this, okay, two orthogonal planes. So one will be like this and other one will be like this. I think let him, is it okay, on this. Similarly this one XZ and ZX, again they are DC, the edge DC, both are pointing towards DC. Arrows are all coming and it is not going in a clockwise or anti-clockwise manner, they are coming and okay. And similarly XY, that is XY means on a X plane in Y direction, on a Y plane in X direction, again the edge is CB. So this one. So this is very important. The shear stresses always act on orthogonal planes in such a way that the arrows are pointing towards each other on the common edge. It is not acting, you know, in any clockwise or anti-clockwise direction. So if there are two orthogonal planes, you must ensure that this is like this. So this I have shown on a positive plane. So these are stresses. Are stress components, in fact stress components, because these are components of the stress tensor on positive coordinate planes. We have forgotten about three negative planes. Negative, there are three negative planes. There is, this is a positive X plane, there this plane O B dash C dash D dash is a negative X plane if you take it. Similarly this one, this is a plane, and then bottom is this one, this one A B B dash O is a negative Z plane. So what about the stresses that are acting on these negative planes, stress component? So let us take first x plane, which is x plane. Now in this diagram it will become complicated, so let me draw it on a separate So yes, negative X plane is this, center of this, that is O, O B dash, C dash, D dash. In fact, best thing will be change this instead of, okay, A. Okay, so on a negative x plane, yes. Now outward normal on the negative plane. See, that plane is the outward normal is in negative x plane. Do you understand? If you draw an outward, a plane is always defined by the outward normal, not by the inward normal. So outward normal to this plane, that means OB dash, C dash, D dash will be pointing in minus x direction. So it is a negative x plane. Okay, on a negative x plane, how to draw the stress components? Because after all, there are how many planes? There are 4 + 2, 6 planes. 6 planes. All the planes must have stresses acting over them. So on a negative plane, yes, stresses will be. I will make a statement here. On a negative plane, stresses will be positive. We'll call them positive if they act in the negative coordinate direction. And there is a reason for it. There is a reason for this. Otherwise, this, see, if you take out this block from the body, this block also must remain in equilibrium. Equilibrium means what? Sum of forces must be equal to 0. So, stress multiplied by the corresponding areas, they will give you the corresponding forces in different direction. So, the sum must become 0. And then it is possible only if we take stresses on the negative planes to act in the negative coordinate direction. Otherwise, equilibrium cannot be satisfied. So, on a negative plane, you have a direction like this. This is negative x direction. On a negative plane, you have a direction like this. That is a negative z direction. And this is a negative. Is it okay? This is in the center of O dash, B dash, C dash, D dash. Back plane, plane which is parallel to this front plane. So, this one. So, then this I will call, this is sigma x, tau x y and tau x z. See, the values are same. It is not that I am showing it by any other. On this plane, it is sigma x, tau xy, tau xz. Now, here they have to act in a negative direction, because if they are not acting in the negative direction, the sum of the forces that are acting in these two parallel planes, front and back, will not be equal and opposite. They have to be equal and opposite in order to be in equilibrium. Of course, all the six, but then first take parallel planes. So, if they are in equilibrium, fine. Similarly, all parallel planes, if the forces are in equilibrium, means entire force system is in equilibrium. So these are also positive stresses. Don't say call them as negative stresses. So they are the positive stresses acting on negative x plane. Is it clear? Positive stresses acting on negative plane. Stress is not negative. If they act in the different, you know, in the opposite direction, then they will be negative. So, these are all positive. So this one is positive. And here also I am showing only positive stress components. Then y plane you take, this is a positive y plane and this one is a negative x y plane, that is dd dash oa. So let me take the center of that plane and show all the direction that are in the negative coordinate direction. So this is one, this is another, and this one is third. Is it okay? So then what will be this? What will be this? This will be tau yy r equal to sigma y. Then this one will be tau yz, and this is tau what? Yx. And now you can see on a y plane and x plane, these also on the negative plane, see they are pointing towards each other. That will always be there. Then we are left with which plane now? Negative. z plane. Z is the bottom one, negative z plane is the bottom one. So here we have the negative directions are z minus, minus y and minus x. Minus x is this, and then this one will be sigma z tau what, tau z y. And see, tau y z and tau z y, just interchange of the subscripts. Y plane in z direction is this, and z plane in y direction is this. They are pointing towards each other. Is it always happens. So these are the positive stress components on negative coordinate planes. If you have any doubt, then you ask me right now. So these are positive stresses on positive planes. These are again positive stress components on negative planes, coordinate planes. Why they have to be like this? Because otherwise equilibrium will not be maintained. Is there anyone who is having doubt that because equilibrium, no sir, equilibrium can be maintained otherwise also if you draw in the positive direction or in the other direction? They have to be like this. If there is a force here, this plane, let us say this is x direction, this is x plane, positive. So this is sigma x. Sigma x multiplied by this area will be the force in this direction. This is negative plane, negative x plane. What will be the positive sigma, I mean positive sigma x is this direction. So this and this, they have to be equal and opposite, because then this component multiplied by this area, the force. See, equilibrium is always forces, not stresses. Stress cannot be equated to force. You know, you cannot have equilibrium with stresses. They have to be converted into forces by multiplication by areas. Then only you can convert. So then this will become equal and opposite. Then this, let us say this is, as I said, z is positive. Let us say y x z, and then again this is x z. See, they are acting in the top and bottom. Now this multiplied by this area, their force will be like this. This force is down. So this. Similarly, in the other direction here, let us say y, this will be y. So they will be equal and opposite. Is it okay? And this has to be done for all the six planes. So we have done only for two. So all the six planes. Now equilibrium requires equilibrium that they have to be. So at any point you have this six. Now it so happens. Now I will leave it for you, for those of you who are smart, to prove for me that this tau xy, this stress tensor is a symmetric stress tensor. I will leave the proof for the time being because there is no time. So xy equal to yx, xz will be equal to zy, and tau yz equal to tau zy. So stress tensor tensor matrix is a symmetric this is a two dimensional 2d stress tensor. 2D stress tensors normally two dimensional. A vector having x, y, z component is called a first order tensor. Okay, this one in a plane, if you are on a small cube, so this is a two dimensional 2D stress tensor, not single. So we are dealing with two dimensional stress tensor. Again coordinate planes. So luckily this matrix that we are talking, tau xs, tau xy, tau xz, you should be able to write it, yx, tau yy, tau yz, then tau what, zx, is it okay? Yes, tau zy and tau zz. So this one is a symmetric. So if you take the diagonal 3 by 3 diagonal, this is equal to, these are equal, this is equal to this, and then this one is a, so 9 components, 9 component gets reduced to independent, 6 independent components. That means all the 9 components of a stress tensor are not independent. I am leaving this proof. Without proof I am saying. So proof I will, I am giving you as a home assignment. You please look for the books, and I want this home assignment submitted, let us say today is what, Monday, next Monday. So I will always give you 1 week's time. On an A4 size paper, whatever you submit must be on an A4 size paper. You write it vertically. On the top, write down assignment number 1. On the right hand corner, write your name, your roll number. Then on the left hand side, you please write down solid mechanics. Then the date when it was given, today's date, 1st August. Assignment number 1. And you write, prove that stress tensor is a symmetric tensor. Okay, the proof is given in, you have to go to the library. Proof is given in, may not be in introductory courses, but take any title of the book which are like theory of elasticity. Take a, you look, you must know how to search books in library. Theory of elasticity, advanced mechanics of solids, any title of the book having advanced solid mechanics or mechanics of solids, they will have the proof. So please understand and copy, three dimensional. Copy with understanding. It is there, and I want you to do this. Okay? So next time you submit, and certainly it will have some weightage. When the grades are awarded, then your marks on this, whether you know how you have done, how you have taken your own efforts, so this will matter. Okay? So next time you bring it. Okay, so this is now what about, now you have got stresses on coordinate planes. So what about this? But then after all, the cube need not be aligned to xyz. It can be any. I can draw a small cube, xyz are fixed, let us say, and cube which is oriented in another direction, x dash, y dash, z dash direction. So supposing you know stresses on, because you are at the same point O, I have told you stress, you can draw any plane. So we have drawn 6 planes which are parallel to the coordinate planes. But then somebody says, no, I don't want to draw parallel to, I want to find out a stress on this plane ABC, which is inclined to the coordinate plane. So that means I have stresses. What is this? These are the 3. So this is X plane. This triangle which I have cut it. Now the cube by an inclined plane ABC, the cube has been cut by an inclined plane ABC. So this is what it will look like. What is this? What you call this? 4 faces. Is there any name? This shape? Tetra. Tetra means 4. Tetrahedron. I'll have to check. But there is a name. Tetrahedron. Okay. okay, so this cube has been cut. I have this was a rectangular, you know, not exactly. So I have put a plane like this, and I have now inclined plane like this, and that is cutting all the three faces. So then now my positive stresses, where is the positive x? So this one is in the negative direction. So you have positive. Tau x z, tau x y, and this is x y, this is x z, where is y plane? This is a y plane, so this is sigma y. So you should be able to draw now tau y z, tau y x, this one is z, so this is sigma z, tau z x, tau z y. Okay, so I have shown the stresses on the three coordinate planes, positive stresses. Now I want to know what is the stress on this plane. So obviously on this plane you have a normal, you have a normal, so I can have a normal x dash, let us call it passing through. So it is difficult to have superposed so many direction on the same diagram, so there will be x dash, let us say x dash is normal to the plane. Let us say x dash is normal to the plane ABC, and then you will have y dash xy, which will be in the plane, y dash will be in the plane, and a z dash again which will be in the plane. So x dash is perpendicular to the plane ABC, y dash and z dash are in the plane, two directions orthogonal to each other, so that x dash, y dash, z dash form a right handed triad. Is it okay? X dash, y dash, z dash will form a triad. So I have taken on this inclined plane x dash, then y dash and z dash, arbitrary. You can rotate this, y dash, z dash can be anything, you know, because then you have to define the direction cosines. How do you fix a fixed coordinate, you know, these directions? You have to have the direction cosines, you know. So these are, you know, I have taken this, and then so it is possible. Again, it is called transformation of stresses. It is possible to transform, that means express. Transform means express tau x dash means sigma x dash, tau x dash y dash, and tau x dash z dash. These are the three stress components on the inclined plane. These are the stress components. Are you with me? Components on the inclined plane, on the inclined plane, I will just, let me write ABC, then yes, what is the, somebody said yes, is there anything, is it okay? These are the three. It is possible to express this in terms of the other nine quantities or six quantities. Now there are only out of 9, only 6 are independent. That you should know. Stress tensor is symmetric. So always, so it is possible to express this in terms of this. Etc. Coordinate. This is called transformation. We can always express, that means one set of stresses can always be transformed into another set of, because I can have a cube which will be now like this. So this is x dash, another plane inclined, another inclined plane. Okay. So it is not only three. I have written only for x dash plane. What about y dash plane? What about z dash plane? So you can express again all the 9 components with reference to x dash, y dash, z dash in terms of x, y, z. It is possible, and that can be expressed. So this again in the same, I will not prove this, no proof or no derivation at the moment. But those of you who are smart, you can read on your own. So this is read on your own. And it is not difficult. How it is difficult? After all, this tetrahedron is in a state of equilibrium. I can sum all the forces in x dash direction. What is x dash direction force on this plane? Sigma x dash multiplied by the area of ABC. That can be written, that has to be equal to, or you write down all the forces that are acting into x dash, in x dash direction. So go to this plane, find out what are the forces in x dash direction. Right now you know in xyz direction, but you can always take components and find out the forces in what is in x dash direction. Similarly, go to this plane and sum all the forces in x dash direction, equate, and you will get this. Similarly in y dash and similarly in z dash. So it is a equilibrium in 3 dimension, nothing else. This you have done as a in the rigid body mechanics. What in the last course, in the first course, this was nothing but this. If the forces are acting on a tetrahedron, can you not write down the equilibrium? You should be able to write down the equilibrium. Only thing, now these are stress components multiplied by this triangular area, then this multiplied by this, multiplied by this, and on this plane it is the total area. Again, this area can be expressed in terms of the coordinate areas, you know, because if I drop this, if I compress this, then this is, they can be expressed in terms of the direction cosines. I can always express area OAB in terms of area ABC. Yes or no? Yes. So this is 3-dimensional geometry which you have done in 11th standard. So you have to make use of this, and then this can be also. So please find out the stress, that means this again, this is another assignment. That means you have now 2 sets of stress tensor, one with reference to x dash, y dash, z dash, and other with reference to x, y, z. So you have this tensor is known, 9 component. I want you to express this and find out these 9 components, tau x dash, x dash, tau x dash, y dash, tau x dash, z dash, tau y dash, x dash, tau y dash, tau y, z dash, etc. Tau z dash, x, tau z dash, y dash, and tau z dash, z. This is the normal with reference to this. So this tensor can be expressed in this and vice versa, just by taking equilibrium of this tetrahedron. So this will be assignment number 2, and this again will be there in the same book, derivation of this. Now I will take here in the class is simple, because in the class we always, teachers always do simple things, you know, and leave the difficult ones for the students to pursue. So I will do a simple problem, and simple problem is this. This is a three-dimensional state of stress at a point. I am drawing on a cube. Not all bodies are in three-dimensional. There are many bodies like this, a sheet of paper, or my this ear planner. This, the thickness is very small compared to this and this. So I will treat this as a two-dimensional body. Thickness is very small. A sheet of paper. This is again, the thickness is very small compared to X and Y. So I will treat this as a two-dimensional. Now when it becomes a two-dimensional, obviously, and if you assume there are ways, and in a three-dimensional body the forces are acting in all the general manner. There is no restriction. And there cannot be anything more than three-dimensional state of stress. You cannot have more, you know, you have to find out only six quantities, not more than six, not more than nine. So those are the maximum. Now, but then if the body is two-dimensional, so 2D body, 2D, you understand what is a two-dimensional body? Yes, one of you can tell me what is a two-dimensional body. Yes. What is this? No, not clear. Okay, you. Yes. That is the points in the body can be defined by simply two coordinates. The third dimension is so small that that can be neglected. The variation in the third dimension is negligible. Okay, so this is a two-dimensional body. So simple definition is a two-dimensional body means if two of the dimensions are larger than the third dimension, then it is a two-dimensional body. Okay, so we will tomorrow morning I will finish two-dimensional state of stress.